Hello students, in this video lecture we will discuss the different steps involved in the manufacturing of glass. In the earlier video we discussed the chemical composition of glass, characteristic of glass material and different type of raw materials that are used in the manufacturing of glass and their functions, why we are using them. So after discussing that, let us discuss what are the different steps involved in the manufacturing of glass. The first step and the most important step is melting. We discussed in the earlier video that different type of raw materials are actually required for preparing a particular type of glass. It means that which type of glass you are preparing, it will decide what raw materials are actually required. So according to your requirement, you take raw materials, and mostly they incorporate soda ash or feldspar or calcium carbonate, silica. Silica is required in the highest proportion, and all these raw materials are actually taken in a definite proportion to manufacture a particular type of glass. When we are done with taking the raw material and their proportionating, they are grounded and mixed. Now we discuss that some broken glass pieces known as cullets are actually mixed with the raw material when we are preparing glass, and these cullets are actually required for making the melting of glass very easy. So the raw materials and the cullets are actually mixed together. Again they are grounded to form a fine powder, and this fine powder is known as batch. Now this batch is heated at a high temperature because we want all the oxide to get fused together, and it will require very high temperature. So this heating is generally done at 1800 degrees Celsius, and at such a high temperature, obviously this heating is done in a type of a furnace. So the two type of furnace that can be used in the manufacturing of glasses, pot furnace and tank furnace. Pot furnace is actually having a pot-like structure, a small pot-like structure in which glass can be manufactured in small quantities. So many pots can be present in a pot furnace, and you can prepare different type of glasses at the same time. But in a tank furnace, there is a large tank in which the melting of glass takes place, and you can prepare only one type of glass in huge quantity. Like say for example the soft glass. Soft glass is most commonly used glass in a different type of applications. So obviously its manufacture will require a huge tank, and huge manufacturing is actually done in the tank furnace. So different type of different colored glass are can be prepared in the pot furnace. So basically in all type of glasses we have to heat these oxides, the batch, and the temperature is actually kept till the 1800 degrees Celsius is achieved. And at this temperature what happens, when you heat the raw materials for very long time at such a high temperature, gases start releasing. So what are the gases? Those are released, generally carbon dioxide is released because we are using limestone here, and this limestone when heated at high temperature tends to release carbon dioxide, and it gets converted into the calcium oxide or CaO. So these gases are actually giving a bubble like appearance to the glass material, the melted glass material, and we have to heat it further till all these bubbles disappear. It means that we have to wait till this glass becomes transparent, the liquid becomes transparent, and then after the release of gases we get a viscous fused mass which is transparent and it is free of bubbles. At this stage the molten glass is known as plain, and this plain is actually having a layer which is known as glass ball or scum. It can be removed manually, and it is actually due to the presence of impurities in the raw material like chlorides and sulfates of calcium, aluminium and different type of alkali metals. So these impurities are removed from the plain in the form of scum, and it is known as glass ball. So when you remove the impurities from the molten glass, the pure melted glass, molten glass, is actually known as plain. And now this plain is molded or shaped into desired glass articles by the process of blowing or molding. These are different type of processes involved when you are preparing a particular type of glass article. So directly this viscous thick liquid is converted into the glass article. Now what happens after you have prepared the glass article? Now since they are since these glass articles are very much hot, so we need to cool them down, and the process of cooling these glass article is a very typical one, which is known as annealing. What is annealing? These heated glass articles are required to cool down in a very specific manner. They need to we need to keep them above a certain critical temperature, which is known as annealing temperature, for sufficient long time. It means that you cannot instantly cool them. You cannot instantly cool them to just to keep the temperature down. You need to cool them in a slow and gradual process. And this is actually what the annealing is. Cooling the glass article gradually and slowly. And this is done by passing the glass article through the series of cooling chambers with descending temperatures. Why is it so? Annealing is very important when we discuss the manufacturing of glass, and this is that is so because glass articles, when if we cool them instantly, what will happen? Since they are non-crystalline in nature, if you cool them instantly, what will happen? The outer layer of glass will remain will be cold, but the inner layers of glass will remain hot, and this temperature difference will create internal strain in the glass material, and this internal strain can result into sudden breaking of glass or decrease in the durability of glass. So what happens? We need to cool it slowly so that this decrease in the temperature translate to different layers of glass at the same time. So what we do? We put the glass above a certain temperature for sufficiently long time. And longer is the cooling period of glass, better is the durability of glass, better will be the quality of glass. So annealing is actually very much required when we are discussing the manufacturing of glass. The durability of glass, the quality of glass, it all depends on the annealing process. After annealing, the glass articles we are getting is actually durable articles now, and they are able to withstand shock and temperature change. Sudden mechanical shocks and sudden temperature change, the glass can only withstand if it is properly annealed. The last stage in the manufacturing of glass is finishing. And this actually includes the cleaning of glass article, its washing, grinding, polishing, all these steps. So this is what the finishing of glass article. Now let us discuss the chemistry behind this process. So basically, the chemical reactions involved in the manufacturing of soft glass. I have taken here the example of soft glass that actually has sodium oxide as a part of it. So we are talking about the soft glass, and all the chemical reactions during the manufacture can be categorized according to the temperature at which they are occurring. So the very first is, at temperature below 600 degrees Celsius, what happens? Moisture, chlorides of sodium, potassium, iron, tin, Na2SO4, and small amounts of so many other oxides that may be present due to impurities like arsenic, antimony, lead, boron, they are actually what evaporated below 600 degrees Celsius. When you further increase the temperature inside the furnace, say at 700 to 900 degrees Celsius, what happens? Now the actual process of this glass manufacture begins, and the soda ash, that is sodium carbonate, get combined with the silica, that is silicon oxide. So these two oxides are actually combining together, and there is subsequent release of carbon dioxide. So this carbon dioxide is actually giving a bubble like structure inside the glass, and we need to heat it for a very long time till all the gas bubbles are removed from the glass. When you further increase the temperature, what will happen here? Again, the limestone that we have used, calcium carbonate, is converted into calcium oxide, and again there is release of carbon dioxide, and this carbon dioxide is actually what, again it is providing bubbles inside the glass material. So again we have to heat it further so that all the gaseous part is removed. On increasing the temperature above the 1000 degrees Celsius, this calcium oxide and silica combines together to form calcium silicate. So basically, sodium and calcium silicates are the major component present in any type of glass. And if you need to impart some specific property, like if you want to prepare heat resistant glass, then you will add boron, and so many other ingredients can be added along with these basic ingredients in the glass. So what is the overall reaction here? Overall reaction is the soda ash is combining with calcium carbonate and silica, and they are preparing what? Soft glass, Na2O, CaO, 6SiO2. And the proportion in which we are taking them is 35 sodium carbonate, 15 calcium carbonate and 100 silica. We need to remember here that silica we are using here, maybe it should be quartz, either it should be quartz, or if you are using ordinary silica, then it needs to be washed before use. There is release of carbon dioxide. Now, if we are using some sulfate salt, like if sodium sulfate and charcoal is added in place of sodium carbonate, then the gases evolved will also include sulfur dioxide. The glass we are getting is same, but in the gaseous mixture, sulfur dioxide will also be removed. So this is a chemical reaction that is happening during the melting process, and the silicates are formed, the mixture of silicates are formed, which is actually known as glass. After getting this molten mixture, we proceed towards preparation of glass articles and annealing and finishing of glass article. So this was all about the manufacturing of glass. Thank you so much.